So we got to ask the obvious question. Is it normal to get into little bad attitudes now and then?
Well, since it happens in my marriage, yeah, I'm going to say yes.
I mean, of course it is. But we need to remember those laws of relationships. Remember law number two. The danger is not getting into a bad attitude, but staying in that bad attitude.
Oh, that's so true. This is how little bad attitudes can ripen into resentments. It all seems to start with some unchecked bad attitude, like a small stone getting in your shoe. Even though you know it's there, it doesn't really seem like a big deal, and you don't want to take the time to pull off your shoe and take it out, so you just ignore it, right?
But after a little bit of time, that stone really begins to dig in, and it starts to irritate your foot. And now it doesn't feel so small. You know, in a similar way, an unchecked negative attitude can begin to grow. Like when you accumulate those little pet peeves of your spouse and then you start to organize them into themes.
Yeah, that would be like if I collected all of the ways that Shirley coached me that I did not like. And then I gave them a heading like, my wife micromanages me. She's so controlling. Now, I need to make something perfectly clear. My wife is not controlling. But you see, if these little negative attitudes continue to grow, my trust picture of her would become distorted. It would be like one of those political caricatures. You know how they, like, for example, draw Bill Clinton with a big nose, or Obama with big ears, or Trump with huge hair, right? Our trust picture takes some feature of our spouse and begins to exaggerate it. You know, make it something more, elaborate it in your own mind.
Yeah, you know, at that point, that little stone in your shoe is now crippling you. So, in other words, your negative attitude has soured into resentment. It will be what first comes to your mind when you think of your spouse or you hear their voice in the other room. Your trust picture has shifted from the good to the bad to the really ugly.
It's like those optical illusion pictures where you see one thing and then you shift your focus and you see something completely different. You know, what you focus on with your partner will change what you see in your partner. If you focus on a negative characteristic, it's going to completely change the profile, the whole picture of how you see your partner. And it will alter, ultimately, how you feel toward your partner.
So true. And it's so important for you to acknowledge that the relationship you have between you and your spouse is greatly influenced by the relationship you have with your partner within your head.
You know, you could actually say that you're married to two spouses. The spouse that lives in the home and the spouse that lives in your head. The between relationship is what you do with your spouse in the home, your words, your actions, your behaviors. But the within relationship is how you think of your spouse in your head, what you focus on. It's your attitude toward them.
And I think some of you may have had longer conversations, usually they're fights, with your spouse in your head versus the one in your home. Like those times you have a 5-minute argument, but then you get in the car for 30 minutes and you just continue that argument in your head.
Those are the arguments I always win.
I say the best things in those arguments.
Write them down.
Well, the Bible says that love keeps no record of wrongs. This is exactly what we mean when we say that the key to success is to make frequent realignments when there is that imbalance. You remember this third law of relationships from session one, and it applies equally to your attitudes. You need to readjust your focus. Rearrange those pieces of what you know about your spouse to take the negatives out of the center stage. You need to run your attitude and erase the record of wrongs.
This is so true. God wants you to run your relationship, and that means both the between relationship as well as the within relationship. Trust is a sacred part of your relationship. And in this session, we really wanted to help you appreciate the responsibility you have for maintaining a focus on the positive qualities of your spouse. Go ahead, make a caricature of your spouse in your mind, but do it by exaggerating all of their good qualities.
Here is a really practical way to realign your trust picture and shift it back from negative focus to a positive one. Every day, hunt for the ways your spouse blesses you. Look for the things they do that meet your needs, how they take care of you, how they help you, how they love your kids, take responsibility. You know, hunt for the good stuff with your spouse. Bring that to the forefront of your mind and put those blessings center stage. And then take it one step further and daily express in words the many ways that they bless you.
Trust is not a feeling of confidence that comes from how your spouse treats you. It really is a feeling of confidence that comes from how you think about how your spouse treats you. The trust picture that you've created, that's what you need to be responsible for, and that is what produces those feelings of confidence and trust. Be aware of the little ways that you begin to shift your focus on something negative. Take responsibility for that. Don't get stuck in the blame game. Put into practice the scripture that says, fix your thoughts on what is true, what is good and right. Think about the things that are pure and lovely, and dwell on the fine good things in another. Take time to reflect on your spouse's strengths, all the ways that those strengths bless you. And listen, running your relationship is more than just what you do with your spouse. It's also how you think of your spouse. Make sure that with all of God's strength and grace, you are running your trust. And that means you're running that trust picture of your spouse.